cabinet took a decision that Barbados should have, will have, a new general hospital to replace the existing Kingsland hospital. So that decision, I think, was taken after exhaustive discussions with all stakeholders, reviewing the proposal done under the former government that looked at the redevelopment in 3H, and we determined as a cabinet that it is better for us to go upon a greenfield site, not in greenfield, on a greenfield site and build a new general hospital. What I would have done is last year put together a team that included the chief town planner, or technically chief town planner, officers, the Ministry of Health, and other key government departments to look at the factors one must consider when determining a site for a new general hospital. And of course, they relate to the demographics, the housing stock, the population information, and reports from the Army Service, issues such as storm surge, and a whole set of issues that they would have looked at coming in there as well. We looked at a couple of sites around the island based on the advice of that particular team. In St. Michael, Christchurch, and St. George in particular. So we wanted it to be essential. Essential meaning not located in the center of the island, but certainly accessible to all based on network of roads, etc. around here. And I'm therefore pleased to let you know that the cabinet of Barbados has determined that the new general hospital is to be located in the general area of Kingsland and Christchurch. On site, we have requested of the Ministry of Housing and Lands that they take the next step forward in terms of working out the ownership of the property. But of course, let me also add, that is the first choice. The other options that have been considered. And that is, of course, subject to geological and soil investigation to be done on the site to ensure that it's adequate for such development. Now, of course, I know the debate will range in terms of is it too far, is it too close, etc. We have nothing to hide in the Ministry of Health. Once this team that would administer the affairs gets settled, we will engage the public in a full and frank discussion, not just about the location, but also the range of services that are to be provided therein. I've taken the position that any new hospital to be constructed in Barbados must be on a parcel of land that is sized to accommodate not just the structure, but have enough green spaces around. So it can be a very therapeutic environment. I don't think we need to build a concrete jungle, but some place where you have enough lawns and trees and waterfalls or fish pond, whatever, that people can relax. They must also have, of course, embrace the latest and alternative energy. I don't think we need to be spending $700,000 a month in electricity charges going forward. There must be the commercial aspect of it as well, so it can generate some revenue from private sources, including our neighbors in the Caribbean, etc. Perhaps the helipad and those features that are deemed necessary in a modern hospital. How do we deal with the non-traditional medicine sector in Barbados? And not necessarily that I'm, you know, casting aspirations on your area, but you know, many mornings you drive along, you hear I come on the radio, somebody's advertising, come and get some medical procedures and things done, etc. that are not licensed by the Medical Council in Barbados. We've also seen within the ministry where individuals have gone to what we call non-traditional medicine folks and ended up in the QEH. With burns, with some serious conditions, like pregnant conditions. It is an area that the Ministry of Health is currently wrapping its minds around. How do we respect and look into the area of alternative medicine as vis-a-vis what we call traditional medicine. Well, these old grandmother remedies that work. I mean, I grew up, you know, having to drink some charcoal occasionally. Or playing off his bad cold. You know, when you go to your bad cold and you go to sleep, you know, say the leaves and salt that will be absent, etc. I mean, there, and a lot of our modern medicines have their genetics in some of these things. So it's not to be discussed as done as the cabinet and the government in the last year. It's the agreed on the decentralization of the ambulance. There was a pilot project started 2 years ago that located an ambulance at the Arch Hall Fire Station. We reviewed the information coming out of that and have decided as a policy that the ambulance service in Barbados will be decentralized and accommodated at the fire stations around the island. This is extremely critical because now the response time will be greatly reduced. When we look at the length of time it takes an ambulance to get to certain parts of the island, and accepting that 2 or 3 minutes can make a difference to whether you live or die or the quality of your life after an adverse incident, we have determined a lot of other factors that we need to decentralize the ambulance service. So the policy has been made in the last couple of months by this government. We recognize, of course, that there are issues with the ambulances on the road, the sheriff's numbers. And hence, the Queen Elizabeth Hospital Board has recently agreed to the procurement of four new ambulances. What's been happening in public service, of course, you go to estimates every year and you get a vote maybe for $180,000 to buy one ambulance. I mean, buy one ambulance. And then they say, oh, they're going to get permission to buy another one. By that time, all the others breaking down across the place. So we said, look, the amount of money it takes to buy one ambulance cash, we can lease 4 or 5 ambulances per year. So this year, we think the order is already in place, I hope, and we should get at least 4 new ambulances in the next 4 or 5 months. Shelly, here is my boy, she got the most time in but hopefully, in a few months, I'm advised that we should have 4 new ambulances. And then next day, we repeat the process to ensure that at all times there's a full complement of ambulances that service the ambulance service. And that, of course, must be accompanied by a good maintenance program. I cannot, as a minister, support buying these expensive vehicles and then they are not well maintained. And including, of course, training and retraining of the drivers and operators at all points in time. So something is happening with the ambulance service, something is happening in terms of pre-hospital care in Barbados. We are working through and near the end of agreeing on definition of an ambulance, so no boy can come and take any Zalar and put on a siren and call it an ambulance in Barbados generally speaking. So and believe you me, we have not made mistakes before. But what exists now certainly puts us in a precarious position. So we're seeking to tighten up on some of these rules, regulations, and definitions in terms of what's an ambulance, also what must be contained in an ambulance, the equipment that must be an emergency response vehicle, an ambulance vehicle. So whenever you call an ambulance, whether it's from the QEH ambulance service or any private ambulance operator, there must be the same standard of equipment, same standard of service, same standard of training of the staff across the board. We will not have, you know, these ups and downs of different services across and there. Also, in terms of the equipment that must be contained on each vehicle is also being agreed to by all. I mean, the hospital records department is definitely not up to par. I'm not going to bury my head in the sand. I emphasize to the staff who work in there. We are working now on a new, for the first time really, disposal policy for hospital records, patient records. You know, we have records that date back 40, 50 years, but only after people have died. And therefore, the Ministry of Health, over the next 2 weeks or so, will announce internally that is a policy that will dictate how long we keep records for, the format we keep them in. Except so that we can get rid of some of the records we don't need. The process of digitizing the record, I believe, that contract should soon be awarded by the Kennington Hospital. They ensure that patient records are digitized. Looking forward, we will get to the stage where patient records are done electronically. The days of writing these notes on a piece of paper and then patients go to the hospital and be told, I can't find your note, come back tomorrow, you go back tomorrow, you're going to come back 6 months later. I mean, these things affect patient care. Not to mention the time you had a cough to have on the trek there several times. It must be frustrating the nurses, to the doctors, and to the patients of all. So we need to put that behind us. And as far as the day when the doctors on the ward, the nurses can put up on the screen a patient record. Of course, certain levels of security and also input some data. That also will help us in terms of reducing the time it takes to get medical reports as well, which is also a major issue. I'm not going to fool myself about it. It is, there are a lot of cases in the court, insurance settlements are delayed because you can't get a report. And sometimes it's not always the doctor's fault, sometimes it's the system that you have to work with as well. So we are going to embrace technology. The Ministry of Health itself is working through a health information system. We will start with the public sector, linking QH, all the polyclinics, job service, etc., in the National Health Information System, and then roll that out into the private sector. So eventually, no matter where you go, your records are accessible, certain levels of security there. In my mind, these reduces the unit cost of healthcare and also improves patient care across the board as well.